So what is the Jaguar XE? Well, it's not just a new Jaguar, it's a whole different market for the brand, because up until now, Jaguar's mainly been associated with making sports cars and performance-inspired sports saloons, although of course now there's the F-Pace SUV as well. The point is, it's never really had a truly mass market car, a car to compete with the likes of the BMW 3 Series, Mercedes-Benz C-Class, and of course, our 2016 Car of the Year, the Audi A4, which you might be able to tell is nestled just over there. Now, I've been running the Jaguar XE for the last 8 months, the equivalent of around 11,000 miles, and there's a couple of things I've noticed in that time. Firstly, the way it looks. I can honestly say I think this is the best looking car in this class, particularly from the front. And it's the little touches. There's these little air grills on the side, and on R-Sport versions, there's an R-Sport badge as well. If we move to the back, there's these tail light clusters, and the keen-eyed amongst you may be able to see that these bits here are reminiscent of those on the F-Type sports car, and they light up brilliantly when you're on the road. The alloy wheels as well give the car a very aggressive, sporting look. Now we're inside the interior of the Jaguar XE, and there's a few things to take note of. First of all, this wonderful start button down here, which pulsates like a heartbeat as you wait to start the car. If we give that a push, you'll hear this 2-litre diesel engine start up. Now, a couple of other points. There's an 8-inch touchscreen infotainment system, which works well enough. It's got all the usual functions, nav, DAB radio, and a range of other functions for the car as well. But it's not quite as slick, and it doesn't function quite as well as the ones you'll find in the Jaguar's rivals, particularly BMW's excellent iDrive system. There's also this part digital instrument cluster, although again it doesn't function as well as Audi's fully digital dashboard display, the same type you can get in the Audi TT, the Q7, the A3, and of course the A4. It's just these little touches which make the cabin of the XE feel not quite as good as that of its rivals. Now, this is the back row of seats. Again, it's pretty standard in here, although we would say this legroom, particularly if you're behind a taller driver and if you're a taller adult yourself, you're quickly going to notice back here. There's also a bit of a fault with these doors, because the XE has a very aerodynamic shape, and that means you get this sloping roofline at the rear, and that means that as you're stepping into the car, you have to remember to duck your head, otherwise you're going to get a very painful reminder halfway down. And I've done that myself a number of times. Back to these seats, they are fine for adults over shorter journeys, but for example, I sat in the back of the XE for a 90-minute trip from our offices in Twickenham over to Silverstone the other day. By the end of the journey, I think I'd lost contact with my legs. Another point to consider is the Jaguar XE's boot. It's not as large as its rivals, and it does slope upwards towards the back, and that makes loading larger items difficult. It also has a fairly narrow opening. So what have we learned during 11,000 miles of motoring with the Jaguar XE? Well, firstly, on the right road and at the right time of day, there really is nothing better to drive. It is one of the best handling cars in this class, and that's especially when coupled with the 8-speed automatic gearbox, which, as you can see, rises majestically out of the center console when you push the starter button. There's also these flappy paddles behind the steering wheel, which you can use to take control if you wish. We do have some complaints though, and the first is to do with the 2-litre diesel engine that rests under the bonnet of this car. It's not what you'd call refined, and even now when we've just started the engine you can hear it humming away, and it doesn't really go away at speed. There's plenty of vibrations coming into the cabin and plenty of noise as well. Our second complaint has to do with fuel economy. When we first got the Jaguar, we were struggling to do even 40 mpg. And even now, it's only when we've got our cleanest driving shoes on that we've been averaging 46 or thereabouts. So there we are, a quick introduction to our long-term Jaguar XE. Now, if you've got a particular question you want answered about this car, do feel free to get in touch. You can get in touch with us on Twitter using the hashtag AskWhatCar, and one of our experts will get back to you. Alternatively, our full review of this car and our video review is now live on the website. So for everything else, head to whatcar.com.